What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome back to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Thanks for hanging out with us for a couple hours this evening. After a week off, we're back and got a lot to pack in tonight. I'm your host, as always, Rob Bertrand. Joining me, Chris Stuber. How are you, Chris?
Rob, what's going on? Another fun-filled Thursday evening. Lots of stuff going on tonight.
Absolutely. I wanted everybody, first and foremost, please thank your wife for standing up on the roof, you know, with the antenna, making sure you've got internet tonight. Now, yeah. I know you're down in Florida. Thankfully, you dodged the brunt of things. Oh, so sure. I was really glad to hear that for you guys. Also, for anybody, any of our viewers that are down in Florida, our thoughts and prayers are with you for a speedy recovery. Hope we can distract you for a little bit this evening. As I mentioned, we got a whole ton of stuff, especially after being off for a week. We've got some great stories and hobby happenings, several box breaks, including two worldwide debuts from Panini America, and hot in the shop as always. But first and foremost, we're going to kick it off with the Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll. And we want to know, if you caught Aaron Judge's 61st or 62nd, so either the tying or breaking AL home run record ball, would you give it to him? And with 115 people weighing in, 57.4% of you are telling the truth. 42.6% of you are telling us what you think we want to hear. No, I'm just kidding. I can't make that statement, but I was honestly surprised to see that it was split as close as it was. And so I guess, Chris, I'm going to ask you, you're there and it's yours. No ifs, ands, or buts. What are you doing with it?
I would give it back to Aaron Judge personally. I wouldn't mind having something back in return from him if he was so gracious to do that, whether it's a jersey or a bat or even a baseball signed. But I believe that's his baseball. He worked hard all year long, and he got that number 61. I think it should belong to Aaron Judge. And it's so great that he gave it to his mother, too. So that's even better. And any fan who wanted to keep it, I couldn't argue with it. It's their right. But that's Aaron Judge's baseball. He deserves it.
All right. Very good. I'm gonna go Oppo.
Okay, that's fine.
I've got two daughters, and teenage daughters. So I've got college, I've got weddings, and the way I look at it, Aaron Judge can afford to buy that ball back if it's that important to him.
Sure.
So yeah, I'm going to be selfish, and I'm keeping it, and I'm selling it, and that's it.
Sure, I think it's just me just working in sports and seeing the guys work hard and all that stuff and just what they accomplish, and just wanted to give them back that kind of memorabilia for their own or whatever they decide to do with it. I just think it's awesome that he gave it to his mother, and she got to share that with her son. That's always cool.
Very cool. So I'm the curmudgeon. Sorry, mom.
No curmudgeons with that. Everyone has their own opinion on that. But there's no wrong answer to this. It's all good.
Few replies on the Twitter poll, and please, if you haven't done so already, please weigh in on that. We'll update the poll later in the program. CowKid1, Brad Connell says, I voted yes, but not for free. I'd want a nice trade of some memorabilia, sure, tickets, meet and greet, but would definitely get it back into his possession. Michael McManus, JGFan24 Forever, says, yes, because it's special and he made a record and he deserves to have it. I'm sure he would give you something in exchange. Ryan Schooling, one and only Fall Guy, says, yes, for the right price. Greg Rearsma says, nope, sorry, not sorry. Yeah. Denny Sports Card says, heck yeah, he did the heavy lifting. He deserves it. Yeah. I would definitely want to meet him, get some autographs, pictures for my collection. Oh, and tickets to the World Series. Grady Malachowski, Grady Fish in the Sea, says yes for a nominal service charge. Cardball 59 Dennis says Roger Maris told the guy who caught 61, keep it and sell it. First class right there.
Sure.
Forrest Barkley, Run Force Run 11, says to be fair, I'd throw it back. You know what the Yankees. All right.
Not a lot of Yankees fans, unless you are obviously from the Bronx.
DX Flyers, Nick Graff says, show me the money.
Yeah.
And Jeremy Walston says, for fair market value. So replies indicative of the split. So again, if you haven't already, please weigh in on that, and we will be sure to update the poll question later in the program. But we have a third person that's part of this Go GTS live crew and team. Let's see how this pans out. Mr. James Gale, what are you doing with it?
I'm giving it back, but getting something for it, whether it's another signed ball or a bat or and something to commemorate the occasion. Definitely a picture with him and the ball. And then definitely an inscribed autograph on something that mentions that. And maybe you could follow me on Twitter.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. Give me a little shout out.
Sure.
A little follow.
Yeah.
That's a nice thing. It's a social media world. So why not? To have Aaron Judge on your followers list is a lot of street cred.
Absolutely.
Even if he doesn't even manage his account anyway. He just has to have his PR person or his agent or manager do a quick follow and mute. I'm fine with that.
See, I never met Aaron Judge. However, everything I hear about the guy, he just seems like a great dude. And he's just one of those guys who has catches with kids in the outfield as, you know, between innings. He gets it. And that's why I think it's, for me, that would be that important to give it back to him just to have that. And I guess James shares that opinion.
Wow, you guys are making me feel really bad.
But no, but it's split. It's a split decision here. Like, even a lot of the listeners are the same way. You know, I think people feel the same way James and I do. There's people who feel the same way you do. There's no wrong answer to this. It just depends on how you want to go about it. But I'm the same way. I would just want to give it back to him. I agree with James. I would love to get a jersey or a ball or a bat signed by him. I guess that would be a trade-off for me. But would I just give it to him? I may just say, here you go. Enjoy.
Somebody in the chat mentioned ask for season tickets for life. That'd be a pretty good
deal.
Because that's an income that you can kind of have continually, right?
Now, something I would consider, because it would also help me out financially, I would ask him if he'd be willing to trade it for the bat he hit it with.
Ooh. See, that's interesting. You know, what's more important, the bat or the ball that you hit the home run with? Obviously, it's the ball that he hit out, but it's the bat that he used to hit the ball out.
That's right.
It's an interesting concept. What is the most important object, if there is? Is it the bat or is it the ball?
Hey, can somebody get Aaron Judge on the horn for us?
I'm curious about that. Like, what would you rather have if you hit that ball out? Is it the bat or is it the ball?
So follow-up poll, if you haven't weighed in and then reply with what you think, bat or ball. Very cool. Very cool.
Yeah.
I love our Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll, because a lot of times it sparks some lively debate and interesting conversation.
Sure.
All right. So over the last couple of weeks, several things have transpired, and we're going to share some of them with you in this next segment we call Hobby Happenings. Some you may already be up to speed on, but erring on the side of caution, we're going to make sure we cover we thought were some of the most important stories while we were gone and even happening this week. So let's take a look at news notes and nuggets from around the web. Well, Sports Collectors Daily reported that two well-known and long-established hobby entities in Trading Card Database and Sports Lots – have announced a strategic partnership. TCDB, Trading Card Database members, will now have access to pricing history data from sports lots to tie into their checklist database. Users will also be able to view current and historic pricing trends for any card sold on sports lots. Sports lots, in turn, will have access to Trading Card Database's non-sports checklist, which the company says will allow the quicker expansion of that aspect of its marketplace into that arena. Founded in 2008, Trading Card Database is a crowdsourced archive of cards with over 16 million different cards currently cataloged. And Sports Lots has nearly 80 million cards in its inventory from over 700 sellers. And a quick note, I have used Trading Card Database for research all the time. If you're familiar with our guide to collecting entertainment trading cards on GoGTS.net, a lot of work and a lot of information pulled from there. I've also purchased from Sports Lots, so I think that's a very win-win situation for both of those companies, and congratulations.
The new online trading and vaulting platform for sports cards and other collectible hard goods has announced a $6 million investor influx that includes two current pro athletes. Sports Collectors Daily reports that Minuswap, which is in the final stages of development, received funding from several venture capital firms, as well as NFL players Odell Beckham Jr. and Kyler Murray. Minuswap lets collectors convert their physical products into digital twins. The tokenized assets can then be bought and sold without the physical item changing hands each time. Users send in their physical items, and Minuswap will then authenticate and insure the cards or other collectibles. They are then vaulted in a secure storage facility managed by in-person auditors and minted as digital counterpart. Collectors can then trade or sell their tokenized digital assets in real time on Minuswap platform and can opt to receive custody of the physical product anytime they wish. Minuswap says the platform allows for real-time trading and instant transaction settlement. For more details, please see the full article on Sports Collectors Daily.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Definitely. Bridging the physical and the digital. Let's see. Well, three trading card dealers end up being among eBay's 10 highest volume sellers in the world, and a total of six are in the top 25. Sports Collectors Daily reports that new data from eBay shows that CompC in seventh place, DC Sports in eighth, and Greg Morris Cards in 10th lead the pack of sports card dealers on the platform. However, not far behind those three top 10 accounts are Probstein 123 in 13th, Burbank Sports Cards in 17th, and a newcomer to the top 25 in the form of Minneapolis-based Two Brothers Sports Cards. Pretty amazing.
Yeah, that's really, really cool. Some hobby justice will be handed out to a Michigan man who will be sentenced next month after he pleaded guilty to repackaging and selling baseball cards in resealed wax packs, including perforated rare issues of Michael Jordan and Wayne Gretzky rookie cards, as well as the 1916 Sporting News rookie card of Babe Ruth, all of which turned out to be counterfeit.
Of course.
Sports Collectors Daily reports that Brian Kennert of Muskegon, there we go, was indicted on 8 counts of wire fraud in March of 2022 and pleaded guilty to the charges in May. He faces up to 20 years in federal prison for each count of wire fraud, with sentencing scheduled for October 19th. There's actually a lot more to this story, including the fact that Kennert is a repeat offender. Read the full article on sportscollectorsdaily.com for more details. So he's not
very
a
bright
smooth criminal. No, not at all.
Not at all. Collectors breaking 2022 Topps Chrome Baseball in search of the rookie short prints of Julio Rodriguez, Bobby Witt Jr., Spencer Torkelson, CJ Abrams, and Hunter Green began to realize something was amiss. Topps issued a lengthy thread last week on Twitter stating in part, quote, the planned bonus short print parallels of five rookie subjects were incorrectly not included in the collation of the hobby boxes, as the short print parallels were originally not part of the set and later added for an additional chase element. There was unfortunately a technical miscommunication about the product mix in the production process. They went on to say that all future shipments of Chrome for customers that have already purchased product through Topps.com, as well as Top Direct Hobby Shops and Breakers, will be provided one two-card silver pack for each 2022 Topps Chrome Baseball Hobby Box purchased. The short print parallels will be randomly inserted in those packs. In addition, it says distributors are also being provided with the silver packs for past and future customer orders. Also, late last Friday, a statement was issued regarding Topps retail customers who were also effective, stating retail customers who purchased and continue to purchase 2022 Topps Chrome Baseball value boxes and or monster box products are eligible for a drawing for an opportunity to receive the short print variations. To participate in the drawing, customers must email Chrome Retail Variations at Topps.com with the following information clearly stated in the body of the email, along with relevant images attached. Full name of customer, shipping address for customer, authentic proof of purchase by same customer. Also, Topps reserves the right to require a reasonable validation of such authenticity. No idea what that means. Date of purchase and proof of purchase must be a valid receipt from a retailer. All info must be clearly visible. Four drawings will be held in total with each with one each month from October through January. For more details on the retail program, visit Topps.com/Chrome Retail Variants. And for direct and hobby accounts, visit Topps.com/Chrome Silver Pack Program.
So you're saying there's a chance you'll get a pack?
I'm saying, well, you'll definitely get a pack. I'm saying there's a chance you might still end up with one of those short printed parallels.
Fantastic. Following the resounding success of Chapter 1 of Heroes, the Batman, the company has released solicitation details for Chapter 2, Black Adam. Good news for collectors who were priced out of the company's first release when the secondary market prices exploded. This release will have strictly enforced maximum advertised pricing policies in place. Here's a quick look at Hero Black Adam.
I was just saying while you guys were watching that, I'm so glad about the maximum advertised pricing policy. So more people have an opportunity to participate in that very cool product. Card ladder indexes, which track thousands of sales of cards across different sports and eras, recently released some market data analyzing the current state of the sports card market. According to findings published by Sports Collectors Daily, modern cards, those issued between 1994 and 2008, are down nearly 20.8% compared to the same time period last year, while ultra modern, those from 2008 and later, are just down a little bit at 4.37%. Vintage cards, meanwhile, those issued between 46 and 1983 are up 13.64%, And pre-war vintage, those cards issued prior to 1945 and earlier, are up 14.65%. Cards for the following players in the ultra-modern category, however, that saw the biggest decreases in the last year, surprisingly include Mike Trout, down 40.87%, Kobe Bryant, down 36.26%, and Tom Brady, down 22.2%. But it's not all gloom and doom in the ultra-modern market, as Aaron Judge is up 110%. Yeah. Josh Allen cards have climbed nearly 142%, and Shohei Ohtani cards are up 39.37%.
It's always interesting that modern versus vintage.
Really, yep.
Is. Pre-grading cards before sending them to be slabbed has always been a cumbersome process and an educated guess at best. Technology platform Doodilly, I like the name Doodilly, which we discussed on past segments of Hobby Happenings, aims to change that pre-grading process using sophisticated computer vision. Watch this. Beckett's recent emphasis on technology, it comes to no surprise that the company recently announced the acquisition of Doodilly. Kunal Chopra, the new CEO of Beckett's Collectibles, said the Doodilly acquisition helps Beckett achieve its strategic vision using technology to create the best products and services for collectors. Computer vision is the future, and we are going to integrate Doodilly's technology and their team to make sure we can provide the fastest and most efficient grading and authentication in the industry.
Which I kind of find a little bit interesting, because if you use the tech and go, I'm only willing to send this in if it's a 10, and the tech says it's a 9, couldn't Beckett technically be setting themselves up to lose money? Unless they're going to charge for the Doodilly usage. I don't know.
Yes, because you're right. When you do submit something for grading, you can put on there that if it doesn't grade a 10, you don't want it to be graded. However, you're still paying for that grade.
Right.
So
it'll be interesting.
Yeah.
I have to imagine they're going to be charging for use of that.
I would imagine. I mean, if it comes to be where it's an accurate service, I think if you are someone who wants to get cards graded, just knowing that the grading process is probably going to be close to 100% accurate, at least knowing what your card is going to achieve, that may just give you the solace of saying, okay, fine, you win. It's almost like you hand over your cards to the dealer and say, you got me.
You got, yep. Well, as we mentioned earlier this year, the beloved Starting Lineup brand has returned to the sports collectibles market. But these aren't your dad's SLUs. Far from it. These 6-inch premium figures feature multiple points of articulation, a custom stand, interchangeable hands, accessories, and licensed uniforms and shoe wear that are specific to each player. In addition, each figure comes with an official Panini NFT trading card in one of 5 parallels. Nice. Figures are now available, but quantities are limited, and they carry a retail price of $50.
I still have my Starting Labs, Rob, so I guess
You can see a couple up there.
You have them. I have so many of them in a crate somewhere in here. New venture capital continues to pour into the sports card market. Darren Rebell reported that Mike Gioseffi, co-host of the podcast Sports Cards Nonsense on the Ringer, has secured $1.5 million led by SGC Grading to fund Card Shop Live, a mobile and web marketplace for buying, trading, and selling sports cards, memorabilia, and collectibles. While the current emphasis on the site has been TCGs, the new funding will allow the company to rapidly expand its offering into sports cards. That's really awesome.
More competition for Loop and whatnot, always. Sounds like. Yeah. Well, Chris, check this out. Leaf announced a pretty incredible redemption program for its recently released Leaf Metal Soccer product. Collectors purchasing boxes should send in their box bottom to receive a limited edition pre-production proof box, which includes one slab pre-production proof autograph card numbered 1 of 1 and a second 1 of 1 base pre-production proof card. All box bottoms must be received to Leaf by October 31st. In addition to this amazing offer, I can tell you that the Leaf Metal Soccer checklist is really loaded with young potential star talent, making this product very much a prospector special. Awesome. For full details, check out Leaf's Twitter timeline.
Fantastic. Effective this month, PSA DNA, which is now transitioning to PSA Autograph, is utilizing slightly redesigned certification stickers for all PSA authenticated autographed items. The new and improved stickers feature an all-encompassing holographic design on the front that showcases a large PSA red and blue logo in the center, right above the item's black alphanumeric certification code, surrounded by smaller silver PSA logos set against all white background that transition from light to dark when held at various angles. In addition, the back of the new stickers possesses a stronger adhesive that better adheres to a variety of surfaces, including signed jerseys, baseballs, footballs, basketballs, golf flags, and photos. Cool. Lastly, the new sticker remains tamper evident like its predecessor and will now leave behind white residue if the sticker is ever removed from a PSA authenticated and/or graded signed item. Tommy Padres, PSA's Director of Product Marketing, said, "We are always looking for ways to improve our products, whether it's through better security measures or improved design. This is just another example of our continued efforts to deliver a better product to collectors." That's really good.
Very cool. And that's a look at this week's and last week's hobby happenings.
A twofer.
Twofer, as we say. Absolutely. All right. Well, we have two box break segments for you this evening. First, we're going to take a look at four Topps products and an Upper Deck NHL hockey product. And we're going to kick it off with highlights from a box of F1 Turbo Attacks. There are a ton of packs in these box and 10 cards per. So highlights was definitely in order. But knowing that there are super, super rare random autographs, I just had to do it.
Sure.
Unfortunately, we did not find an autograph, but the cards themselves are pretty cool. And what we're going to do, Chris, is we're going to give away this whole box to someone.
Oh, yeah. Wow. And if you want to win that box that Rob just graciously is giving away, go on to the Go GTS Live Twitter account and also just retweet and make sure that you're watching the show at the end and throughout the entire time that we're on. Retweet the tweet that starts with, "Are you ready for some box breaks?" It's on there now live. Just retweet it and watch the show.
All right. So we're going to start things off. I'm going to close one of my windows here so I can see better. All right. So we've got cards of nice. Cars.
Cars.
So I am not familiar with how to play match attacks, or in this case turbo attacks, but as you can see, there's different scoring attributes. Cool. And then we've got team duos.
I should learn more about match attacks. Is it like a video game in your hands?
Like, kind of, yeah. It's like a TCG, a trading card game.
Cool.
Epic Moments, Sergio Perez at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Track Masters. And the cards have this really, just this unique feel to them.
it looks like a gloss type.
Yeah.
Does it have a little gloss to it? Like a
gloss and a little texture as well.
Okay.
Pretty
like
cool.
There's like a little bevel to it, maybe?
I wouldn't go that far. It's kind of hard to describe. I've been trying to think about it. Heroes, Alfa Romeo driver, Valtteri Bottas. Live action.
I like the black look to it.
Yeah.
It's nice and sharp. Very cool. It really stands out.
Every pack has foils, though. Silvers are nice most common.
Sure.
Superstar, Lewis Hamilton. F1 World Champion 2021, Max Verstappen.
He's fantastic.
First ever record breakers, first ever F1 driver to 100 wins, Lewis Hamilton.
Pulled a lot of Lewis Hamiltons.
Grand Prix booster card, Charles Leclerc for Ferrari.
Another good one.
And then there's another tier of pink foil.
Okay.
Parallels, superstars, Alex Albon. Grand Prix booster, Pierre Gasly.
Nice.
Valtteri Bottas. Stat attacks, most overtakes, Sebastian Vettel, 132.
Cool.
2021 race winner, Esteban Ocon.
Nice, like his name.
Stat attacks, most laps raced in 2021, Carlos Sainz, 1,294.
Good one.
And then rare.
Ooh, whoa, okay.
Gold limited edition of Max Verstappen.
That's a good one. Is that a boom?
I would call that a boom.
That's a boom. Okay.
I would call that a boom.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a good cross section of what you can find in match attacks. Again, we didn't find an auto in the packs we opened, but we are going to send this box out.
Wow, that's awesome.
To a winner so that you can check it out for yourselves and maybe even learn how to play the game and give us a full report back. In fact, if you want, if the winner receives this is something that's up their alley, we'll even let you do a guest post on GoGTS.net on how to play Turbo Attacks.
Oh, that's awesome.
And we'll even give you an author byline.
Sure. Yeah, a little credit. Why not?
Absolutely.
Time to write something for us.
Absolutely. All right. So from the racetrack to the pitch, in the form of a blast from the past brand that's back for its sophomore year, Merlin. And this is a look at 2021-22 UEFA. So we've got Champions League, Europa, and Europa Conference League in here. One chrome autograph card per box. Again, pre-broke this for time's sake. So here's a look at highlights. I'm going to put my glasses back on so I can butcher the pronunciation of these names.
Nah, well, the spectacles help, Rob. So here goes.
Well, this one's an easy one. So some key rookies, Jonathan David.
You got to start with an easy one.
Anthony Alanga.
Here you go.
Zidane Iqbal.
Good.
Oliver Skip. Luka Sukic.
Right.
And Gavi.
That's a good one.
Now, there were a lot of other rookies. These were the ones that we knew.
Sure.
So we showed those off. Chris helped me with that.
I tried.
Then there is in every pack, you're going to find a refractor.
Here we go, Rob.
Here's Zlatan Abramovich.
Fantastic, Rob. The spectacles helped. The power David, of the spectacles.
David Alaba. Heng Men Son were some of the key ones we found.
Wow, I've been practicing. I love it. It's great.
And then we found some shiny color as well. Abrima Darbo, rookie pink. Pinks are numbered to 275.
Right.
Kyogo Furuhashi.
Sounds about right.
Kind of the Atomic.
Yeah.
Numbered to 250. And then we found a gold Atomic of Chrislane Matisma, rookie. Uh-huh. And these are numbered to just 50.
Fantastic. Merlins are really cool cards.
Yeah, Merlin is cool. And they got a little bit of a thicker stock to them, too.
Nice.
Yeah. Some cool inserts in the form of under 23 stars, Felix Afena Guyan, mm-hmm. Malik Tillman, Luka Sukic again.
Yeah.
I thought this was great.
Yeah.
Ageless Alchemy, Eric Cantona.
That's a nice looking card.
And I thought this was pretty nice looking too.
Nice.
Prophecy Fulfilled, Romelu Lukaku.
Uh-huh.
And Erling Haaland.
All right, there's nothing wrong with him.
And then our autograph, Ryan Gravenberch.
Okay.
Ryan Gravenberch.
Very
cool. So I'm going to, you know what? I'm just going to give this whole stack away to one.
Wow.
One
winner. Very generous tonight. I like it. He's always generous, but even more generous tonight.
I'm going to say this probably at least one other time on tonight's program because of the industry summit and me leaving Sunday and having to close.
Oh, good. He's coming back.
Having to close the pool, pack all sorts of stuff Saturday. Chances are this stuff is not going to get shipped until we are back on air for another show. So I'm saying there's a 10% chance.
Okay.
All right. Next up, we have Topps Chrome Baseball. We will not find any rookie short print parallels in this box.
You know, it happens, I guess.
And highlights from this. First, we got to show off a little Wander there.
Yeah. Didn't have the rookie season many expected, but still a good little player.
Couple key rookies. Brandon Marsh.
He's a Philly now. He's not doing too well.
And Jake Berger.
Dropped another ball in center field today. Ridiculous.
Joey Gallo, refractor. Austin Riley, refractor.
Nice one. Yeah.
Dansby Swanson, refractor. Refractors and rookies, pretty liberal throughout the product. Those were some of the keys. Then Wave Refractor, Casey Mize,
all right.
Trent Grisham, Brian Delacruz.
They're so pretty, those cards. Yeah.
And Alex Manoa.
Nice and shiny.
Color shiny.
Okay, even better.
Pink Jack Flaherty.
Yeah.
Numbered to 350.
Nice.
And Adolis Garcia, sky blue, numbered to 199.
Yeah, he had a great year last season. He's really hitting a lot of home runs last year.
Now, you guys know how much I absolutely loathe 1987 Tops, but I gotta say,
it's the Chrome.
I gotta say, this works for me. This works for me in Chrome.
You know what it's like, Rob? It's like it's a nice little sealant on the wood, right? It's like,
yeah, there you go. It's like a little varnish.
Machine. Yeah, right? It's like a new deck.
Jacob DeGrom. Jose Abreu.
Yeah, yeah.
Brandon Marsh. And Timmy Anderson.
They are sharp.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. All right, some fun inserts. Future stars, Ryan Mountcastle and Randy Arozarena.
It's a good one.
However, it was these inserts that really did it for me.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
New That's classics nice. With Shohei Ohtani.
Uh-huh.
New classics, Wander Franco.
Nice.
But let's Ooh. Dive into how okay. sharp is that.
That's beautiful. Is that like a variation? Is that like a special...
I don't know what this insert is because this insert, the name is not on there.
Okay.
And it's not, yeah, it's not a base card. P9. I'm sure one of our viewers knows. But I just think those are absolutely phenomenal.
Very sharp. Yeah.
And then I really loved this. Heart of the City.
There you go.
Art the of the City.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah.
The bean. Yeah.
Yeah. And if yeah, you've sure. if you haven't seen that bean, it's cool. You I've stand in that, front yeah. of that and it just mirrors that whole Michigan Avenue skyline. It's very, very cool.
Just don't go into wintertime at
night. Yeah, don't do
it's
that.
It's not good. The lake effect wind is for real.
Yeah. But I thought that was just a poppin' design. So nice. Well done on nice. Some of those insert designs. All right. Two autographs in every box. Our first is Michael Brantley, and autos are on card. Not nice. Numbered, but uh-huh. Michael Brantley. And then rookie refractor Helio Ramos. Nice. And that one is numbered to 499.
Oh, fantastic.
Okay. I'm going to pull out those two color cards okay. and some other goodies, and I'm going to split those between the two. So the Helio Ramos and some extras, and Michael Brantley and some extras. All right.
Two prizes from Chrome.
Next up, brand new sealed box of 2022 Museum Collection Baseball. MLB, 4 hits per master box. Nice. You're definitely going boom hunting. On-card autograph, autograph relic, quad relic, or auto. Each mini box guarantees one of the below.
Oh, yeah.
Let's do it.
Fantastic. This is always a beautiful product.
Yeah, it is. There's your 4 mini boxes.
Maybe we'll pull a Aaron Judge bat relic. What we were talking about earlier. It's more important, the bat or the ball. Meeny, meeny, miny, mo. All kinds of goodies in this bad boy.
Right, Sandman.
Yeah. There we go.
Hey, there's Aaron Judge.
Sure.
Wilson Contreras.
He's a good one.
Huh. Ooh, that's a cool looking.
That's really nice.
Red. That's the Canvas Collection insert.
Yeah.
And it definitely feels like it. So going with that whole museum art motif. I should say.
Really nice.
Very cool. And wow, we got a Nolan Arenado triple auto. Very cool.
That's nice.
Number 2199.
Wow.
Triple relic autograph. Nolan Arenado. All right, so we'll give that to one lucky winner.
I have an update on the Juan Soto insert.
Okay.
From NJ Sensation in the chat. That Juan Soto, it's called Pinstripes is the name of the set. And he says it goes for $10 to $20.
Nice.
So nice little card. Yeah.
Thank you, James.
I'm surprised it doesn't say pinstriped on the card. That's interesting.
Yeah, right.
But and P9. Thank you, Justin.
P9, right. Yeah. Oh, cool. Tony Gwynn there. It's nice. That's a young Tony Gwynn.
Yeah, it is. Thin Tony Gwynn.
And he actually stole bases.
Christian Yelich talking on the phone.
Right.
Oh, no. He's just got that, that like wrap around.
Looks like it, though. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Rookie Cal Riley. Jose Altuve.
Did they make helmet phones back in the day?
On card autograph.
Oh, yeah, Philly. I know who that swing is.
Matt Vierling, number 299.
Not a bad player. Notre Dame kid.
So, we'll get that to one winner. Still looking for a boom.
Well, the Arenado was a good one.
It's a good one. I'm gonna hold off on calling it a boom.
Well, he's one of the best players in baseball, Rob.
All right, maybe I'm spoiled.
It's not Aaron Judge or anyone, but I mean he's pretty good. I mean he's a really really good player.
He was in the MVP race. Is he still? I guess I can.
No, it's gonna be more Goldschmidt, I would imagine.
That's what I thought. Yeah. It was like him and Goldschmidt, and then Goldschmidt kind of pulled away. Yeah.
So, rookie O'Neill Cruz.
Yeah.
Helio Ramos. Brian Dela Cruz.
Rookie box.
Yeah.
Justin Verlander.
It's a good one.
Who, Dual Auto? No, dual. It's a dual. Dual memorabilia. Gerrit Cole and Gleyber Torres, numbered to just 50.
It's not autographed, but they're Yankees. So it's always a good thing when they're Yankees when it comes to baseball cards.
There you go. So we will give that to, you know what I'm going to do? Yeah. I'm going to pair that puppy up with that super awesome museum collection. Oh, Reggie.
Yankees a lot there.
Yeah. And that's how we roll.
It's worse.
All right. Last mini box.
Let's get a big hit here. Fire hands. Let's go.
All right.
You want that? You want the big hit? Let's go. Let's make it happen. Make it happen, cap him.
Blake Snell.
Alrighty.
Derek Jeter.
Ooh,
Lou Gehrig.
The Yankee box.
Roger Clemens in the Toronto uniform. Yeah, interesting.
Yeah.
This one's chunky. Hit's chunky.
Oh, we like it. Okay.
Quad.
Yeah.
Brandon Lowe, numbered to 75. Brandon Lowe, numbered to 75.
Not a bad player. Decent player.
So we'll give that away. So four winners out of that box. Brandon Lowe.
Sure.
The two Yankee cards. Matt Vierling.
Yeah.
And
that's a good one. That's a really good card right there. And
the top hit from the box for
probably sure. Top 10 player in Major League Baseball?
Ooh. Yeah.
Top 10 in the National League.
There you go.
But no, Arenado's great, and I like that there's the powder blue jersey swatch on there.
Sure.
Love the powder blue St. Louis.
Best uniforms. Third baseman in baseball, no question.
Yeah, I'll give you that. Yep. All-stars.
All right, so that wraps up tops breaks. We went from the track to the pitch to the diamond. And now I'm going to head to the ice with upper deck artifacts. And yes. Yeah, now bear with upper deck as they catch up on some products.
Oh, yes.
Of all the manufacturers, the supply chain issues really did hit them the worst.
Is it a California thing?
I think it's a California thing. You know, I was talking to them. I mean, things that you just don't think of. Adhesive, think of all the multi-layered cards they do in different substrates. So even though we're getting ready to start the 2022-23 season, and typically this is when artifacts would be coming out. We are just now getting 21-22 artifacts hockey.
Yeah.
But we are glad we are, and we're going to check it out right now.
It's always interesting because we deal with the solicitations every day, Rob, and you know, we'll have a 21-22, we'll have a 22-23, we'll have a 2021.
Yeah, it's been crazy. It's been absolutely crazy.
But they keep on pumping out the product. That's always good.
8 packs, 4 cards per pack, up to 3 hits in every box. They define hits a little differently. How are we defining hits, Chris?
Yep, let's see here. Just bear with me. My internet's been a little slow.
So. Really? Down there in Florida where there was a hurricane? A little slow? Yeah.
Sorry. So just bear with me.
I'm just happy you were able to make it on the program, dude. I was getting ready to fly solo if I needed to.
I gave you a warning. I know. Thinking I wouldn't be able to work today. I was able to work today, so thankfully.
All right.
It's still loading. I'll get there.
It's all right. Martin Jones, Connor Garland. Parallel, Drake Batherson, number to 299. Advertising.
Always important.
Braden Schenn. Got to throw those decoys in these packs for sure.
Of course you do, yeah. So I appreciate the advertising in every pack. Good. That's a chunk.
It's a chunk. Yeah, I think it is a chunk on in front of the decoy.
Yeah.
Pierre-Luc Dubois. Mackenzie Blackwood. There we go. Jersey card.
Nice.
Seth Jones, when he was on the Predators, the team he was drafted with. So.
So, yep, you get 3 autograph cards, memorabilia, and a Rome cards, 4 serial numbered cards, and 1 rookie redemption card or clear cut acetate card.
This is the one that has the Orem cards in it, right?
It is, yeah. You can get 3 autograph memorabilia or Orem cards. So,
is there a bounty program this year?
There is a bounty program.
Nice.
And there's an Orem bounty program.
Okay.
So it's a 48 card set within a set.
Good to know. Kevin Fiala. Gabriel Landeskog. Love that guy. His game is awesome. Rookie, Kalen Addison for the Minnesota Wild.
Nice.
Number to 999. You know I was waiting for it, James. Another wild player, Zach Parise, one of the best American-born players, maybe ever.
Yeah. Great one.
Minneapolis St. Paul native.
Is he?
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Nice.
I don't know where he went though. Where did he go after the Wild? Because they got rid of him and Suter.
I'm not sure. I know he came from the Devils, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So somebody in the chat, tell me where Zach Parise went.
John Gibson. Jacob Varna. And another rookie, rookie goaltender Justice Annanen, numbered to 999.
I really love those jerseys, the Avalanche. I've always
Me too.
I mean, they're just fantastic. And not to, and also the Nordiques were one of my favorite jerseys of all time. So they went from the Nordiques to the Avalanche, which is awesome.
John, in the chat, John Bastow said he went to the Islanders.
Okay. Tyler Bertuzzi, boo, dirty player. Mark Giordano. Oh, Seth Jones, when he was on Columbus. Steven Stamkos, green parallel, number to 99.
That's a good one.
Yeah, you think? Yeah. Great player.
Hall of Fame player, probably.
Yeah, for sure. Without a doubt. Without a doubt.
A legend down here in Tampa, that's for sure.
I'm sure.
Nice house down here in Tampa, too.
Thatcher Demko. Jason Robertson. Hey, there's one of those Orem cards. Yeah. Rookie Jovellino.
Nice.
So definitely have to give that away.
Yeah.
So we got that and the Seth Jones so far to give away. Shea Theodore.
Nice.
Jason Zucker. Ryan Suter.
Oh, okay.
Brett Hall. Number to 499, red parallel.
Nice one.
Mm-hmm.
Can't go wrong with Brett Hall. I remember when I was a kid, I was like 12 years old. I mean, you were probably like me. You just went through boxes of cards all the time and just looked at the same cards. And I went through just one box one time, and it felt like 10 different times. And all of a sudden, I came across a Brett Hall rookie card out of nowhere. It's like I missed it the other previous nine times somehow. There it was, like magically appeared. Brett Hall.
James Van Riemsdyk. Netgear, Martin Brodeur. That's a nice one.
That's cool.
I like that. Very cool. Nice thick card there. All right, so we'll give all three of those away. Move these over here. Because it was so much fun the first time.
You got two?
I got two. Twofer.
Wow. Nice. Look at you, Magic Closet Special. Or Upper Deck Special.
Yeah, it came when we were off, so they've definitely been marinating.
Nice. Magic Closet produces magic. Shuffle action. Like it. See if we can pull a big boom out of this one. I see a flyer there. There we
go. Pious Suter.
Okay. Lots of suitors.
Carter Hart.
Yeah.
Tommy Grice. Dougie Gilmore as a flame, young Dougie, 199.
Hmm. Cool card.
Maxime Comtos, Tyson Berry. Nice. That's a solid one. Semyon Varlamov, dual jersey. I love the matching color there, the dual swatch. Yeah. 249. Nice color match. Absolutely beautiful. Nice.
Nice card. Nothing wrong with relics. I like relics.
Nope, especially I mean that, you know, when it just hits the color,
sure. Sure.
Scheme. I mean, that's just, that's tight. I like that. Carter, Verhage. I'm going Verhage. Jordan Binnington. Oliver Borkstrand. Nice. Hey, Hurricane. Right. Speaking of Hurricanes, 499.
Great player. Surprised they didn't actually trade him, though.
They needed... I've talked with my buddy who I, you know, been going to Hawks games with when I lived in Chicago all the time. And we said they needed to break up that team probably 4 years ago.
Yeah, they waited too long.
They waited way too long. Mm-hmm. And now, I mean, yeah. I mean, they really, really screwed themselves. I mean, Stan Bowman needs to go as GM of that team. He did a great job building them in large, but it was also, you got to remember, Dale Talon was there. He helped make the draft picks, but then he screwed them on the salary cap. They haven't had a GM that can do it all. Sure. Like, well, start to finish. Yeah. I mean, and Stan had his dad Scotty's ear and, you know, the advice of Scotty, but I can't believe they held on to that team and it was way too long. Well, anyway, I'll get off my soapbox.
Once you trade the Brinkat, though, what's the point of keeping Kane?
Oh, it's just, yeah. Right. I mean, Kane was who you could get the most for, and you would have gone deep with picks if you traded him even three years ago. Yeah. Josh Bailey.
You can get something decent now, though.
Hey, people know this guy. NHL remnants of Connor McDavid. I mean, they call it artifacts for a reason.
Yeah. Nice relics. You gotta like
them. Absolutely. Yeah. Hawks are a mess.
Why is that a mess?
At least you got a backup team. In Tampa.
Oh, yeah.
JT Miller. Mikko Rantanen, solid player. Philippe Forsberg, great player. Green parallel, Oliver Borkstrand, number to 99.
Nice.
Wanted to get a shout out to Mike Yoffman, who is the winner of the Mandy Rose autograph card.
That's fantastic.
On our last show, and he was willing to work a trade, and that we successfully culminated, and everybody's happy.
That's great.
Nick Suzuki, Dominic Kubalik, Kevin Lankinen.
Oh, okay.
Ooh, Alexander Teixeira for the Blue Jackets. Nice auto. Nice. Good young player. Some solid adhesive on these packs.
Well, they had to wait for it for a long time.
I guess. They just doubled up on it once they got it. Rasmus Dahlin. Jacob Voracek. Thomas Chabot, number to 299.
Nice.
Silver parallel. And Adrian Kemp.
Nice.
And our last pack of artifacts.
Maybe a huge boom here. Let's see what we got.
Nikola Eller, Logan Couture, Yanni Gourde. Artifacts rookie number 2999, Anton Lindahl.
Okay.
Anton Lindahl. All right. Let me see something here. I'm wondering if it's going to make sense to pair this up
into
three winners.
Three winners?
Yeah. Oh. So let's see. How about we go the Auto and the Aurum.
The Velena Aurum.
To share Auto and the Velena Aurum. Yep. Then we're going to go Connor McDavid and Seth Jones relics. And third winner will get the Semyon Varlamov and the Martin Brodeur. Save myself a little bit of work.
Sure.
So six nice hits, three nice prizes for winners. All right, that's going to do it for our first box break segment of the evening, but don't go anywhere. Coming up shortly, we've got our second box break segment featuring two worldwide debuts, world debuts of NFL Score NFL football and Panini Prizm baseball, as well as a look at another new release this week, Panini Elements.
Very cool.
NFL football. But first, there is a new comedy, a new collecting focused comedy out that's streaming on Amazon Prime right now. Gem Mint is a new comedy about a fanatical baseball card collector. And we've got the trailer for you. Check this out, and we'll be right back to update the poll question.
Hello? Home, may I ask who's calling?
Excuse me, did you say a mantle?
That card might be worth something. Hard to tell.
Hello, everybody. In today's episode, I'm going to be showing you one of these hot corner boxes. These are usually terrible. Not bad, not bad. By not bad, I mean pretty bad.
And the thing is, she doesn't even know how much it's worth. God only knows what else is in that collection.
Mantle rookie.
Hey, you want Chinese?
Oh, hell yeah.
You know, there's a lot of scummy people out there. I just would hate to see a nice old lady like yourself be treated with disrespect.
Why are people commenting that they haven't gotten their Patreon orders yet this month?
I know, I got them already at the house, but it must have slipped my mind, all right?
Wait. Tone, look, listen to me. I know you're mad at me right now, but I need you to call me back. It's an emergency. It has to do with the Mantle rookie. It's me, your brother Billy. Call me back, okay?
I'm coming through. Stay there. Thank you. Let's go, Grandma. Come on.
That's my card, Jay.
Yeah! Yes!
Keep your eyes out for some good cards. This is Gem Mint signing off.
Gotta love media about this hobby we love. So that's something we will for sure be checking out in its entirety. Hope you guys do as well. Now updating that poll question. If you caught Aaron Judge's 61st or 62nd home run ball, would you give it back to him? 188 people weighing in still. Let me just do a quick refresh, make sure I had that count right. Yep. Still 51 minutes left to vote if you haven't done so already and would like to do so. Things have tightened up a little bit. 55.3% saying no way, Jose. And 44.7% being extremely benevolent and saying yes.
To me, there's no wrong answer though, Bob. But, you know, we discussed it in the beginning and I said I would give it back to him. You said... Nah, my daughter's in college tuition. I have bills. All that. I know there's no wrong answer to this one. I just like to have fun with Rob. But I think it's an interesting question. But as I mentioned earlier, too, and as we discussed, What is more important, the bat or the ball? That's an interesting question too, because he keeps the bat. That's his bat.
I mean, I want the bat.
It doesn't go to a fan. Yeah, the fan gets the ball.
I'd take the bat. If he was that hot on the ball, I'd try to work a trade for the bat. But
genius move to get.
Yeah, it would. See.
And also, Aaron, you have to sign that bat too. You know.
That's right, and date it. I hit number 61. Yep. All right. I'm gonna switch back to my box break setup here because we've got the world debut box break of Score NFL Football. This is a monster product with 400 cards in it. So we did some pre-breaking, but not the entire thing. And there's a specific reason for that. So I want to show you guys some of what we found inside first. Okay, so a lot of diverse content in here. A monster base set. So, okay. So, in addition to finding,
you get 4 autographs in every box.
Yes, you do.
You get 90 rookies, 36 inserts, 10 parallels.
Yeah, tons of rookies.
Yeah,
rookies like Kyren Williams, who apparently suffered a concussion of some sort, and
is that a whammy?
I don't know what. I have never seen a helmet like that, but it is certainly special. But anyway, in addition to finding rookies like Kyren Williams out of Notre Dame, or kickers like Justin Tucker, I mean, we're talking a deep.
It's like every play in the NFL.
Yeah. But then you also got, you know, your stars like Rob Gronkowski, young stars like Devonta Smith. I threw that one in there for you.
I love it.
Russell Wilson. We also get some old school like the Bus.
I like that. Yeah.
About prime time.
That's cool.
Charles Woodson.
Great player.
And one of the most.
Great player right there.
Yeah, great player. A little bit underrated, if you ask
me.
Always
underrated, yes.
Curtis Martin.
Yes.
Okay, so in addition to that, let's see. Let's check out some of the key rookies, because of those 90, here's a look at some of the key ones we pulled. Chris Olave.
Yeah, good one.
Malik Willis.
Nice.
Drake London. Garrett Wilson.
Did a big touchdown a couple weeks ago.
Desmond Ridder.
Oldest rookie,
John Ritchie. Can't show one of his cards without you saying that.
No, it's just amazing.
Breece Hall, Carson Strong,
no longer an Eagle.
Derek Stingley Jr.
Third overall pick.
Kayvon Thibodeau,
monster from Oregon.
Aiden Hutchinson,
Michigan monster.
All right, then you get a gray parallel, gray border parallel in every pack. Kyler Murray.
She played baseball.
CJ Mosley. Jalen Windermeyer. JD McKissick.
Teddy
Bridgewater.
Okay.
Then we found some number parallels. There's that very special helmet on Kyren Williams.
That just looks like a whammy to me. You know whammies I'm talking about, right? From baseball. Where they have the big heads.
Yeah.
It just looks so like Photoshopped to me.
It's so bizarre. Real.
That's actually a cool card that
I know, you know, I've never seen that. I mean,
it looks Photoshopped. It looks too like
it's bizarre. The helmet they used at training camp.
Yeah,
I know, but still kind
of it does look blown up though. It looks bigger than it should. Yeah,
it does. It looks like someone had fun with it.
Numbered to 100. Jahan Dotson, numbered to 100. And the Score showcase, draft showcase, and then gold parallel rookie of David Ojabo, numbered to just 50.
Yeah, he went to Michigan, and he, I believe, he tore his Achilles during his pro day.
And as Chris told you, 90 rookies in every box. I mean, that's an absolute. I mean, look at that chunk.
Sure. Those cards are great to get autographed too. They
Yep, just use an eraser to erase the gloss before you do.
Sure.
All right. In addition to lots of rookies, this, I am always impressed by the inserts. Now you have your regular, I should say, kind of standard inserts. So we'll do those first. Hot rookies, Aiden Hutchinson. Hot rookies, Kenny Pickett. Nice. Hot rookies, Derek Stingley Jr. Then you've got your fantasy stars. Okay. So interesting combos there. Dak, Jalen, Joe. More fantasy stars. Another fantasy star. Okay. And then, you know, still kind of, you know, your draft is kind of, you know, insert.
So right.
Jameson Williams, Treylon Burks,
yep.
Sam Howell, Breece Hall,
yeah.
Kyron Williams. Okay. But now we get into the meat. All right.
There we go.
Squad. The team cool. cards are awesome. Yeah. Check it out. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Super fun.
James, looking for the Vikings. Did you pull the Vikings?
I did not.
No. Oh.
Fun. Oh, are you sure? Eagles.
Yeah, really great photography.
Nice. Yeah, super awesome photography. Another one that I really thought was awesome. Toe the Line. Hunter Renfro.
Nice.
Cooper That's Kupp. A
cool one. Yeah.
AJ Brown.
That's not an Eagles uniform.
Oh, Devonta Smith.
That's nice.
And then breakthroughs. This one was awesome, too, cool. I thought. Justin Fields. Mac Jones.
Yeah.
Trevor Lawrence.
He's playing really
Yeah, well I thought this now. Design just really worked. Javonte Williams. Mm-hmm. And Eli Mitchell.
Nice.
So cool. Cool Very inserts. Cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I kept two packs sealed,
yeah.
And I can tell you one of them will have an autograph.
That's always good.
Because the last pack we're going to show has the other three autographs.
Okay, cool.
But the reason that I kept a couple sealed is because I wanted people to see the kind of the how the makeup of the pack break, if you will.
Sure.
And if you haven't, you know, because this is the world debut, haven't seen any breaks yet. So you're going to see a lot of breakers be doing this. You got right. all your veterans yeah. up front, and then there's more. There's a flip there.
Mm-hmm.
And then right too. There yep. is your rookies. So Bailey Zapp. Jalen Pitre, Andrew Booth Jr., George Pickens, Trayvon Walker.
Playing well, yeah.
Reggie Roberson Jr., and then Channing Tindall. And then then your inserts. Okay, so another squad.
Oh, here we go.
Hot rookies, Kenneth Walker III.
Yeah.
Drake London draft. Breakthroughs, Kyle Pitts.
Nice.
And last card in the pack is going to be your gray parallel. This one is of James Robinson.
Nice.
All right. So no auto in that one means there's an auto in this next pack.
So the case hit in this too, if anyone's interested in the case hit. It's the
We love some case hits.
It's the intergalactic insert. It's a lenticular technology. So that's the case hit that people will probably wanting to get out of score. So maybe we'll hit one. That'd be pretty cool.
All right. Let's see. I got to make some room here. I got to get rid of all these Upper Deck advertisements. But I pad cards, shipments with those sometimes. Put those away. All right.
Here. These chunky packs.
Yeah, 40 cards per pack. Look at that. Yeah. It's a brick.
It is a brick. It's a brick of goodness. We like it. See what we get here. Maybe a nice boom.
All right. So Your vets.
I saw Jalen Hurts. He's doing really well this year.
Yeah, he is.
Probably leader for MVP right now, I would say.
All right. Nick Benito, Charlie Kohler.
There's another big head. You compare that big head to the other one, it's night and day.
Isaiah Spiller, Tyquan Thornton, Ronnie Quiver or Rivers, excuse me, Sam Howell.
Nice.
Perry and Winfrey, Evan Neal, Jameson Williams. Hold on, got a text. Gotta check on my sister.
No worries. It's important.
Okay. Everything's all right. Chris Olave, hot rookie. Yep, I see the upside down. A couple. Let's see. Fantasy stars, toe the line. Nice. Dante Hall. There we go.
That's a good one.
That is a solid one.
One of the best returners of all time.
And then Adam Thielen, Gray.
Human joystick.
Yes. All right. And I'll show you the other three autographs that we found. And I'm going to tell you right now, there's a boom in there.
There's a boom?
There's a boom.
All right. I made sure Rob didn't tell me anything pre-show. So
Reggie Roberson Jr., rookie.
Okay.
Jameson Crowder.
Okay, that's good.
Next up, numbered to just 20. How about a little Hines Ward? Nice. Numbered to 20.
Nice signature, too.
Big.
Boom.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do, two winners, the Hines Ward and the Reggie Roberson and the Jameson Crowder and the Dante Hall. So two winners. Okay. Yeah, it's a solid auto right there. Great photo. Solid signature.
Oh, yeah. Nice signature.
Numbered to just 20.
That's a beautiful one.
Absolutely. Wet the old whistle there. All right. Second World debut box break. This one, Prism Baseball. So we're going head-to-head, Battle of the Shiny Baseball tonight. And we're going to get three autographs in every box, 12 cards, 12 packs per box, 12 cards per pack.
Very cool. That Hines Ward was a great card, though.
Yeah.
I really signed that nicely on that sticker, so. Nice and centered. It's a lot better than the
box is huge.
Darius Tony.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. There's autographs that I remember. I'll always remember them. For the wrong reasons.
Okay.
Lots of good stuff in this one, too. Color Blaster in this. You got the lava flow inserts as well, so that's a really cool stuff. And you never know, you can get a hot box. There's one in every case.
And what does a hot box entail?
It contains 24 exclusive parallels.
Holy cow. All right, Eloy Jimenez, Verlander, Walker Buehler, Bryce Harper, Flip, Azer Sanchez. Oh, come on. Jesse Winker, Pete Alonso, Yike.
Yeah.
Joey Votto, Fearless. Nice insert. That's cool. Salvador Perez. Okay. Ooh, a little nice illumination. Little trout illumination.
That's a nice one.
And it's numbered to just 99.
Ooh.
Hey, there you go.
Even better.
Solid.
That's a great one.
Willie Adams Blue Parallel, unnumbered. And Sluggers, Jordan Alvarez.
If I remember correctly from our hobby happenings, did that really say that Mike Trout's cards have decreased 41% or something like that?
Yes.
That's unbelievable.
I find it unbelievable too. But every, you know, not, no, I don't really, I'm going to take that back. I don't find it unbelievable. I think the market was set for a correction. I think that's kind of what we're seeing.
Sure.
Ian Anderson.
He's almost around 40 home runs. It's crazy.
O'Neill Cruz, rookie. Riley Adams, rookie. Rafi Devers. Illumination. So that's what the regular one looks like. So you can see the bling, 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 blingy of the Trout.
That is a nice Trout.
Salvador Perez. Connor Wong, rookie.
Oh.
Greg Dykeman auto. Greg Dykeman.
Okay.
Rookie. Silver Prism, Anthony Rizzo. Emergent Timmy Anderson. These cards are going to fall all over the place. I just know it. I got to clean up a little bit here.
It was probably that score, the 40 cards in every pack.
The 400 cards, yeah.
Yeah. That did it. It's okay. We like cards.
All right. Mike Bowman, Kyle Tucker, Jacob Robson, Yanni Hernandez, Francisco Lindor, Curtis Terry, TJ Friedel, old school, Mark McGuire, Jorge Polanco, Championship Stage, Silver Prism, Ronald Acuna Jr.
Okay.
Yanni Hernandez, red.
Nice.
Aaron Ashby, rookie class.
Nice. There's also the different tiers in Prism, too. You got tier one, then you got tier two and tier three.
Shane McClellan, Chaz McCormick, Andre Jackson, Degatti, Juan Soto. That's a little bit of a different pattern. Jacob DeGrom, illumination.
They're asking to see the back of any base card. Doesn't matter who.
Just a
random base, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know what he's looking for.
Tier three.
Yeah. So tier three is the most rare one.
Okay.
And then obviously you got the base ones and then, you know, tier two and then tier three.
So similar to select in that they have like what
field? Yeah. Premier. Like concourse and premier level. And then, so they're just,
okay.
But they don't all say what tier. So like if it's tier one, it doesn't say anything, but then like base, there's right. tier two.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, sure. Makes sense.
And obviously, if you get a Prism that's like a tier three and it's a really good player, more money involved with that one then.
How about a green Alex Bregman numbered to 125?
Ooh, nice.
Solid.
Yeah.
Jose Altuve, illumination. And I like this insert too, fireworks, Jose Ramirez. So very nicely done with the inserts on Prism. Byron Buxton, Trevor Story. Remember when he was the hottest thing in baseball?
Yeah. Yeah. Still a really good player, but.
Nick Cortez, Reed Detmers, Yuli Gurriel, Fearless, Trey Turner.
Full guard.
Fernando Tatis Jr.
Remember when he was one of the hottest things?
Yes. Nick Allen, Salvador Perez, Sluggers.
Things change, I guess.
Quickly.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He was once probably the most popular player in baseball, and probably not any longer.
It's a shame too, because
it really is. He had a lot of good things going.
You don't, you know, half of these guys that end up juicing, they don't even need it.
No, they don't. They don't. And his excuse was just ridiculous too. At least own up to it.
Vladimir Guerrero Jr. Sebastian Riviero, rookie. Jose Abreu. Ooh, nice, another nice trout. Little stained glass action.
That's nice. Two nice trouts. Oh, a Kirby Puckett.
That's look at that, place. James.
Ooh.
Kirby.
Love it. Powder blue twins, too.
Yeah.
Ooh, that hard.
Otto Lopez gold. Ooh. Rookie auto. So that's going to be, you know it, it's numbered to just 10.
Wow. That's pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah. And then that stained glass Harper. Look at that.
That's a nice
look Harper. At that.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
is beautiful.
Nice.
Really nice. Those stained glass not, cards are so nice.
That not numbered?
It is not numbered, but it is beautiful.
Wow. Because that's like a blue too, right? Compared
oh, to yeah.
Trout, right? So.
Yep.
Okay. Not numbered on
that one. You know, here, I'll show them side by side.
That's pretty cool. You got a Trout and a Harper stained glass. Oh, wow. Yeah. Beautiful cards.
Hey, Spencer Torkelson.
Yeah.
Brian Hayes.
Yeah.
Jake Cousins. Anthony Rizzo. Fearless Javi Baez. Max Scherzer, rookie, oh, auto, wow. Aaron Ashby, Red Cal Riley, Matt Manning, rookie class.
Pretty cool cards that we've been pulling here.
Excuse me. Patrice Mazika. You want Makeda, Hunter Green, Jose Siri, Josh Bell, Catfish Hunter.
Wow.
Sorry, guys. Tim Anderson. Francisco Lindor, Fearless. Okay. Joey Votto.
That prism, yeah.
Blue Lucas Giolito. And Lumber Inc. Okay. Jose Abreu.
Nice.
Marcus Semien. Pitchers.
No one collects pitchers, I don't think.
Zach Rex.
Only Hall of Famers.
Remember yeah. when Steven Strasburg was the hottest thing in the hobby?
He was. Yeah.
Oh, old That's school. Cool. Ken Griffey. Chris Bryant.
That's pretty cool. Mojo. It's maybe out 25.
199.
199? Okay.
You were close.
I was way off.
Mitch Haniger, blue. And Stargazing with Yadier Molina.
Nice. That was a blue mojo, I guess. I got the serial number wrong. He's finally got cards, huh? Stephen Kwan. I remember he was one of the hottest hitters in the beginning of the season.
Willie McCovey. Illumination.
There you go.
Bryce Harper.
Nice one.
Harmon Killebrew.
Ooh. That's a good one.
Jaron.
Yeah.
Duran Auto.
That's a good auto. Yeah. That's a nice one. Give you a nice JD.
Bryce Elder. Emergent. Trevor Story. One pack left after this one. Jackson Cower. Freddie Freeman. Alex Verdugo. CJ Abrams.
Yeah.
Stuart Fairchild. Charlie Blackman. Miggy, Dallas Garcia, Jordan Alvarez Fearless, Vidal Brujan, Josiah Gray, Rookie Silver.
Nice.
Tier one, Austin Riley, Sluggers. And last pack. Clayton Kershaw. Kettle Marte. Alex Bregman. Cal Ripken.
Oh, another Trout. Wow. Lots of Trouts.
Ichiro. Hoyeon Park, red.
Nice.
And Reed Detmer's rookie class. All right, let's take
like four Trouts in that box.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. Standing alone is the Otto Lopez, numbered to 10. Aaron Ashby with the Trout Illumination.
John Bastow in chat is claiming we hit one trout per pack.
Wow.
I wouldn't be surprised if he went back and rewatched and saw that. But yeah, that's wild. Great box.
Really good box, yeah.
Let's do Jaron Duran and the blue Bryce Harper.
Okay.
And then we'll do Greg Diekman and the green Alex Bregman. So four winners. Three of them get two cards. Otto Lopez, gold auto number to 10, stands alone. But we're not done yet, folks. We got one break left.
Four winners. Yeah, we got a lot of winners today so far. It's good.
Oh, yeah.
Not good for Rob, but good for
I'm just kidding. Again, just a reminder.
It's Friday tomorrow, Rob.
Because of traveling. Yeah, the only way this stuff is getting shipped tomorrow is if tomorrow is a slow day at regular work.
Yeah.
So
Friday, so you never
everybody know. Can knock on wood, and that's the only way they're shipping out before next Rob, week.
Slow Fridays are like case hits.
I know, right?
No.
Few and far between.
Exactly.
All right. Is that your guy? Is that your guy on the? Is that a little? Who is that?
Malik. No, that's Malik Willis. Close. Yeah,
it's Malik Willis. Okay. Yeah.
Who'd you think it was?
I didn't see Titans there.
Okay.
I was wondering if that was Jalen.
Jalen? No. Yeah. You know, if it was Jalen, I may say keep the box for me. But, you know.
All right. Elements football. What's the box break like? Let's see. Find one on-card metal autograph per box on. Ooh, I don't like that on average, but they got to put it in there.
Yeah, do it. Yeah. What's my page?
Oh, it's in there. This pack is heavy.
They got metal cards now. That's maybe why. They're metal.
They're great. I'm looking forward to
this. I was hoping that we would get this product. So thank you, Scotty Prusha.
Scotty's a man. I met him for the first time at the National. He's a really nice guy.
Yeah, great guy. To peel or not to peel?
I never peel.
Yeah.
I still have finest cards from like 96 that still have the peel in pristine condition.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Good for you.
I never peeled them. So you get one autograph card, one memorabilia card, one base or rookie metal card, one base or rookie metal parallel, and one additional autograph card in every box.
Thank you, sir. You're welcome. All right. So there's Zach Wilson metal.
They're really, oh, they are awesome. No wonder they're heavy.
Kyle Hamilton, yeah. Rookie.
Yeah. I would never peel them. I mean, I wish all cards came with a peel. Then you wouldn't have to really worry about scratching.
Right? Especially all the shiny stuff.
Yeah, like chrome, all that's the prism. Oh, yeah. Put it on there.
All right.
Oh,
look at that.
Wow.
Rookie neon signs. Velius Jones Jr. for the Bears. That's cool. Sick. That's a great signature, too. Those turned. I like that. That's,
yeah,
that's
sharp. Fun. Is that a parallel then?
Number to 125.
Okay. That's good. Yeah.
So an orange.
Oh.
Hey, nice little patch there of Christian McCaffrey. Nice.
Mm-hmm. Is that numbered on that one to get that kind of color?
It is.
Okay.
How about to just 27?
Wow.
That's nice. To get that kind of color, I thought it had to be a little bit of a number there. Because you don't get those.
You got the whole, Captain America shield going on there. Yeah. And
right.
Whole lot going on there, man.
That's nice. Yeah, it looks really
good. And then our on card metal auto. So I'm very curious. So do they sign the metal and then they put the top sheet on, or are these not going to have the peel sheet?
I would say no peel sheet personally.
No peel sheet. Fred Warner, you're right. No peel sheet, steel signatures, but that really is cool.
That's nice.
I like that.
Yeah, looks nice. Yeah.
And so definitely, those three, and you know what, four winners. I'm gonna put the rookie and the vet, so four winners. And that's going to do it for our box break segment.
What's the auto? Is Fred Warner?
Yes, Fred Warner.
And then who was the other one? It was Velus Jones?
Yeah, it's Velus Jones Jr.
Okay. And then it was Zach Wilson. And then
but the rookie was Kyle Hamilton.
Raven.
All right. Cool.
Nice. So those are nice, pretty cool cards.
Yeah, very cool. Like elements. Like elements a lot. All right. Very cool.
You got some shit, my man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Got some winners here.
All right. So in addition to artifacts, score, prism baseball, and elements, we have a handful of additional new releases that we'll talk about right now in Hot in the Shop. Kicking things off with high-end football in the collegiate variety, 2022 Panini Immaculate Collegiate Football Cards. Four autograph cards, one memorabilia card, plus one base or base parallel in every box. Immaculate Collegiate returns highlighted by premium patches and autographs of top draft picks of the 2022 NFL Draft. Five boxes in a case, one pack, six cards. And as we mentioned, some booming hits, booming hits to be found. So as an example of those booming hits, how about rookie autographs paired with college jersey swatches of the top picks? Plus, there's parallels featuring conference logos, brand logos, bowl patches, and team slogan signatures, as which includes school's motto, a jersey swatch background, and an on-card autograph, plus all-time great signatures. Look for key rookies from the 2022 draft class, Immaculate Moments, Immaculate Jumbo, and helmet pieces, hat swatches, chunks of cleats, collegiate helmets, player caps, and more. Plus, you get that one base or base parallel. The checklist is up on GoGTS.net. Check it out.
Next up for us is 2022 Leaf Flash Football Cards. It delivers five autograph cards in every box. Leaf is pleased to announce the return of its ever-popular Flash Football hobby release. Look for an incredible selection of 2022 NFL Draft top prospects, plus elite NIL superstars. It has 12 boxes and five cards as configuration. It's a limited production run. Find themed autograph inserts, including Flash Forward, Flash Photography, Flash of Color, and Flash of Brilliance. Lots of flash in this, obviously, Leaf Flash. Look for a variety of parallel colors in this stunning release. Chase dual autograph cards featuring the NFL draft analyst, Mel Kiper Jr., alongside top draft picks, which I think is fantastic to have Mel Kiper Jr. on a football card. It makes a lot of sense, especially an NFL draft card. Find an incredible roster of the biggest names from the 2022 NFL draft. And NIL superstars, including Sam Howell, Malik Willis, Matt Corral, Bryce Young, Kenny Pickett, and many more. This is just a fantastic set. The checklist is on the Go GTS website. Check it out today. This is a great product that you'll want to get your hands on this week.
Yes, it is. I also am a big fan of pairing one of the premier draft analyst autographs with a card of a draft pick player. Okay, from the gridiron to the diamond, the minor league diamond, pro debut baseball in hobby and jumbo. Hobby boxes have four autos or relics plus 10 inserts, and jumbos have three autos and 36 exclusive base set chrome variations, plus two inserts in every jumbo box. So big difference between hobby and jumbo. It's not always the case in Topps products. Big difference this year in these two SKUs or configurations. Autographs, base set autograph variations with parallels numbered from 150 down to 101. New this year, jumbo exclusive, as we mentioned, base set chrome autograph variations with refractor parallels, orange lava numbered to 25, red to 10, and super fractor 101s. Look for future cornerstone autographs, MILB legends. New brick by brick autograph, laying a foundation for a major league franchise, I have a feeling. drafty debuts and draft board quad autographs. Nice. Some of the insert cards are that Brick by Brick and the drafty debuts. Those are new, and MILB legends. The 200 card base set includes some new parallels, including Fuchsia number to 199 and Aqua to 75. Checklist for this is also up on GoGTS.net.
2022 TriStar Hidden Treasures Diamond Stars Autograph Baseballs delivers one autographed baseball in every box. Uncover baseballs autographed by Hall of Famers, Diamond Stars, including current stars, young talent, award winners, and more. Hunt for one of three Diamond Treasures single-side baseballs of Ted Williams, Mickey Mantle, and Joe DiMaggio. Configuration for this is 12 boxes and one autographed card. Case contents are three Hall of Fame greats and nine Diamond Stars. All autographs have been authenticated by PSA, DNA, TriStar, JSA, and BAS. Chase Diamond Treasures single signed sweet spot autographs of Joe DiMaggio, Ted Williams, and Mickey Mantle. Find specialty baseballs, including 24 karat gold, vintage inscribed, commemorative issued, and more. Find stars of yesterday and today, including Nolan Ryan, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Shohei Ohtani, Mike Trout, Sandy Koufax, Pete Alonso, Tom Seaver, Aaron Judge. We all talked about Aaron Judge, Mariano Rivera, Randy Johnson, and many more. This is a limited production run, only 100 total cases. This is a fantastic item that if you're a big baseball fan, you'll want to get your hands on. It's available this week. Go check it out.
Yeah, some of those treasure hunting. I mean, yeah. Who wouldn't mind a single signed baseball from any one of those three players?
Fantastic.
Yeah, in fact, I have two of them, Mantle and Williams.
Yeah, you have a Mantle?
Yeah.
Nice.
I've got, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I've got 18 500 home run club hitter single sign baseballs.
You have 18 of the 27?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Who are you missing?
Well, Babe Ruth and Mel Ott.
I didn't know you had Mickey Mantle. Maybe you had Babe Ruth. I don't know.
And many of the more new players.
Okay.
Many of the juicers.
Okay. Do you have Barry? Do you have Barry Bonds?
I do have a Barry. I broke down a lot of Barry.
Now, is it a sweet spot one? Because he didn't.
It is a sweet spot.
Okay, that's nice. Okay.
Yeah. Yep. Just real quick before we do close out hot in the shop, two more products in select locations. Leaf Pop Century 1-of-1 pre-production proof, super limited, and 21-22 Donruss Optic Fast Break NBA basketball cards. Released despite never receiving a sell sheet, so we don't have any visuals to show you. So those two additional products as well. And that's going to do it for Hot in the Shop. All right. We're going to put Chris to work pulling some winners. While you guys do this, Kelsey Schroyer, back on the floor at the National Sports Collectors Convention, had an opportunity to talk with Panini about the NBA draft, as well as representatives from Beckett about the acquisition of Wata video game grading. Watch this, and we'll be back to announce tonight's winners.
All right, guys, the 2022 NBA draft wrapped up a couple weeks ago. Panini had a huge presence there. Overall, how do you think the draft went for the company?
Overall, I think it went amazing. With Paolo going number one to Orlando, of course Chet going two to OKC, and then Jabari going three to Houston. We got three top rookies in awesome markets. collectors should, you know, should have a great time going after these awesome looking cards we're going to be putting out of them this year. Patch autographs, on-card autographs, you name it. We're excited for it. Could have gone any better from our standpoint, if you ask us.
Yeah, we've been talking to Paolo for over a year now, so, you know, he was our guy going into it, and we're happy that things ended up the way they did. We just got back from Summer League, too, and I got to tell you, the group of guys are amazing. They're all excited to be a part of trading cards. They're excited to sign their stuff, and they want to do it. So it's been a great experience so far.
Yep. So overall, when are we going to see the guys in their pro uniforms and Panini products?
Well, we've already done our photo shoot, so everybody that we invited to the shoot, and we saw 38 rookies, they'll already be in their uniforms. There's no cloning jerseys this year. And then as the other guys start to play, we'll work them into the sets as soon as we have new photography.
Our first release will obviously be the Hoops release, a very fun, popular program, you know, for collectors of all spectrum, you know, all over the spectrum. But we're really looking forward to getting the year started. Not only the top, you know, to mention the top three, you got guys like Keegan Murray, Jaden Ivey, you know, guys like that who slipped out of the top three who we think are going to, you know, be making noise all this year. And we can't wait to see how these rookies come out and perform and in turn see how these products do with collectors.
So we know the big names from this year's class, but who's an under-the-radar guy collectors should be looking out for?
I'll tell you, he wasn't under the radar last year, but he is now because where he was drafted. I'm looking for big things from our Dallas Maverick guy, Jaden Hardy. He's my sleeper pick for this year.
Jaden Hardy's a special player. I can't argue with you there. I'm not going with the second rounder, but I'm going with Nikola Jovic going to Miami Heat. Guy's a shooter. He can play. He's look for him to excel very quickly with the Miami Heat team. He should be able to contribute to them right away. I think he'll be a good sleeper to get on early.
Here at the 2022 National Sports Collectors Convention at the PSA Wadabo with Dan and Andrew. Guys, you've got a pretty impressive display of video games here. What more can you tell me about them?
Yeah, so we've got a collection here that showcases a Madden game from every year that it released, including the very first Madden here, the first console release of any Madden game. So these are extremely limited in supply. You know, this is a sub-top 10 title. Really incredibly valuable. You know, there's the recent sales of this copy in similar condition has been, you know, approaching six figures. So very valuable collectible, very hard to get your hands on. And every game here has never been opened before. They're all still factory sealed and authenticated. So really impressive to pull something together for a, you know, a franchise that's coming up on 30 years. So.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, with video games especially, like kind of like Pokemon cards, they're meant to be played. How often do you see sealed copies of these games after all these years?
Well, you know, with sports games, a lot of the times they only have one printing or they have very few printings because in the following year, the new Madden came out, right? So some of these games in factory sealed condition are actually really hard to find, especially some of the older cardboard stuff. But even if you look at some of the newer modern stuff, like the Madden 22, the bow nose down there, it's actually really hard to find. We think it's a giveaway from the Raiders. That's what we can establish so far. But they're incredibly rare modern examples of sports games also. But you don't see a lot of these in factory sealed condition.
So let me ask you this: out of all the video games out there, which one is the most popular one to be graded?
Really anything that hits on one of those key franchises, right? So a Super Mario, a Legend of Zelda, Sonic the Hedgehog, anything with that huge mass appeal, right? Like Mario has more name recognition worldwide than Mickey Mouse. So, it's a gigantic franchise. Anything with one of those super iconic characters is going to definitely get a lot of attention. It's a lot of what we see being created.
All right. Thanks, Kelsey Schroyer. Good stuff as always from our man of the people, boots on the ground, while we're running the main stage. All right, so Chris has informed me we have 21 winners to announce this evening.
You have 21 envelopes to seal.
All right, so this is what you got to do. If you hear your name called, what you're going to do is you are going to email the show, GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. you're going to get us your full name, your mailing address, your Twitter handle, and what you won. Your full name, your mailing address, your Twitter handle, and what you won to GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. Every show, it doesn't fail. Somebody tries to reach out on Twitter to claim. Please don't do that. We don't want it to get lost in the shuffle or missed or something like that. GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. Chris, all you, bro.
You got it, man. 2022 Topps F1 Turbo Attacks. The entire box that Rob has to ship right there is all yours. And that lucky winner is at Gator Cubs. Congratulations, Gator. You won that entire box. Got a nice Max Verstappen in that, I believe. A nice gold.
Yes.
That's nice. 2021-22 Topps Merlin Chrome UEFA Soccer. And again, it's the entire box. The entire stack.
Well, not the entire box.
Stack. The entire stack. Yeah, this is the stack.
All the highlights.
And that one goes to at the Angriest Chad. Congratulations there, Chad, on winning that stack of cards. Coming your way. All right, we have 2022 Topps Chrome Baseball. We have two winners from this great box. And we will start with the Ramos autograph and plus the extras that Rob is going to throw in there. And that goes to at Chef MS, or I should say at Chef M Smith 04. That's what it looks like. At Chef M Smith 04. And then the Michael Brantley auto plus the extras, that goes to at QCR28. Congratulations, guys and gals, if you're either one. Congratulations. We have 2022 Topps Museum Collection Baseball. And we will start with Matt Vierling's autograph. That goes to at Evan Collects. Congratulations, Evan. Then we will go with Brandon Lowe Quad Relic. And that goes to at Go St. Louis Blues. So it's STL Blues. Congratulations. Then we'll go with the Yankees lot, which is the Gerrit Cole and Gleyber Torres Relic. And then the Reggie Jackson Canvas. And that goes to at Thacker underscore T. Congrats. And then also the big hit from that box was the Nolan Arenado Triple Relic Auto, and that goes to at Ricky Hedrick 23. Congratulations, guys and gals. 2021-22 Upper Deck Artifacts is up next, and we have three winners from that box. And we will start with the Semyon Varlamov Dual Relic, and then the Martin Brodeur Netgear Relic. And that goes to at KRSP70. Congratulations. Next up, we have the Connor McDavid Relic and the Seth Jones Relic. That goes to at, okay, this is a new one, at D Mackey Lakers fan. D Mackey Lakers fan. There you go. You won that one. Okay, Andre Texier, auto, and then the Valeno Orium, that goes to at RickMassFan67. Congrats. The new ones I'm going to struggle with because I haven't seen it before, and that one was all stuff there. So there we go. Got it right, though. 2022 Score NFL Football. We're going to start with the Jameson Crowder autograph and the Dante Hall autograph, and that goes to at FergTM underscore. Congratulations.
21 winners. And if I hadn't paired up and tripled up some of this stuff.
Yeah, it would be a ton. It would be, we would have a ton, probably like 50 winners. And then we have the Reggie. That means we had a lot of good stuff, right? So the Reggie Roberson autograph and then the Hines Ward autograph. And this is a nice one. That Hines Ward, beautiful right there. And that goes to at Fox Bull 330. Congratulations, Fox. 2022 Panini Prism Baseball. We had four winners from this box. There was a nice hit from this one as well. But we will start with the Dykeman autograph and the Alex Bregman green. And that goes to at Jason W. Rocco. Congrats, Jason. Next up, we will go with the Aaron Ashby Auto and the Mike Trout Illumination. That goes to at Rasner Sarah. Congratulations, Sarah. Next up, we have the Jaron Duran autograph and then the Bryce Harper blue stained glass. And that goes to at Elesdi, that's ELESDI underscore 16. Congrats. And then the big winner from this box was that beautiful Otto Lopez autograph out of 10. And that goes to at Biggie 2911. Congratulations, Biggie. Congrats all you guys on that one box. And now we have four winners from 2022 Panini Elements Football. Beautiful box of cards here. We will start with the Zach Wilson and then the Kyle Hamilton cards. Nice little lot there. And that goes to at BDLEHMAN18. So that's
hey,
Layman 18.
I just noticed something.
Oh, you find something good?
So... yeah, both cards ended up being both of those cards end up being numbered.
Ooh.
120 of 199 on the Zach Wilson and
yeah, that's a nice one.
33 of 74 Ooh. On the Kyle Hamilton rookie.
That's a nice little bonus.
Yeah.
Nice.
Details.
Discovery there.
Yeah.
It's all the details, right? So we'll go with the Fred Warner autograph next up. And that goes to at MetJetFan55. I'm sorry, you're a New York fan and that doesn't play well, but you won. Congrats. I love you, though. Thanks for watching there. Next up, we have Velus Jones Jr. autograph card. And that goes to at G. Walt Wartner. I said that wrong. At G. Walt Wharton. G-E-W-A-L-T. R-T-E-N, Dewalt Wharton. Congrats. And then we had the Christian McCaffrey patch. Beautiful patch there, too. And that goes to at Seawalt 816. Congrats. And to claim your prizes again, as Rob said before we went through all the prizes tonight, to claim it, you have to go and email us, gogtslive@gogts.net. With your full name, your Twitter handle, your mailing address, and also what you won. Congrats, guys. Thanks.
Nicely done, sir. Nicely done.
Thank you.
All right. One quick programming note. With me traveling to the industry summit next week and getting in at about midnight on Wednesday, there is no way I'm going to be putting together a show for Thursday. So we're going to be off next week, returning the following week after that. That's going to do it. So first and foremost, I want to thank all of our manufacturing partners, Jonathan Matros at Topps, Scotty Prusha at Panini America, and Paul at Upper Deck for providing some great product for us to check out this evening. Thanks to James Gale behind the scene, keeping everything running smoothly, making us look good. And as always, thanks to my co-host and partner in crime here on the show, Chris Stuber. All right, we will be back in 2 weeks with an update on recap of the industry summit and a whole lot more on Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. In the meantime, you know what to be doing. Always be collecting. Have a good weekend, everybody. Good night. We'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.